Hi everyone, Teddy Baldassare with TeddyBaldassare.com. In this video, we're looking at a watch from Bulova with the Bulova Chrono A. So in this video and on this channel, we cover watches available for purchase on our website, TeddyBaldassare.com, as a full authorized dealer. So in this video, what we're gonna do, go through a full in-depth review, also look at some final points of consideration. But throughout this video, if you have any further questions, check out the link in the description to the product page where you can learn more, purchase the watch, as well as book a time with one of our dedicated watch specialists as well. But guys, let's jump into the video, take a closer look at this watch. In the 1970s, the American watch company Bulova produced a collection of popular diver chronograph watches called the Deep Sea Surfboard Chronographs, which was a reference to the oval-shaped center dial that looked like the silhouette of, you guessed it, a surfboard. Today, these original chronographs are highly collectible, and to pay tribute to them, Bulova launched a tribute series in three different dial configurations back in January of 2020 called the Chronograph A Surfboard. Now on this channel, we have looked at the automatic versions that were going to be priced much higher than the ones that we're gonna be looking at here today. So this Chrono A that we're gonna look at here today is going to be the option to go for if you're trying to get into this design, but doing it on a more conservative budget. Taking a look at this Chronograph A Surfboard on the wrist, we have measurements of 40.5 millimeters across with a 14.5 millimeter thickness and a lug to lug distance of 46.5 millimeters, giving this case a compact yet sporty feel and look. Compared to the original surfboard case design from the 1970s, this piece runs a few millimeters larger to accommodate today's market, while also refining the overall shape by tapering the lugs down a bit more. With that said, there's no denying that the vintage 70s shape is definitely on display here in its execution, straddling the line between round and to-no shapes. On the wrist, it feels pretty true to that 40.5 millimeter size and wears a little thinner than the 14.5 millimeter thickness really lets on. Part of that is going to come down to the sapphire crystal that is going to accompany this piece, going to add about 2 millimeters to that total thickness. Still by no means a thin watch on the wrist, but just keep in mind where that thickness is going to reside. That 46.5 millimeter lug to lug distance though is going to make this watch wear true to that 40.5 millimeter case size, if not a little bit smaller when you're talking about from north to south across the wrist. Along the right side of the case, we have a signed screw down crown with the surfboard shape found on the dial applied to the top surfaces as well as the Bulova name embossed within. Flanking the crown on both sides are the chronograph pump pushers, which operate in typical fashion, starting and stopping the chronograph with that top pusher, and then the resetting function of the chronograph will be done with the bottom pusher. Don't be alarmed when there is this general sweep back to the 12 o'clock position when engaging the reset. That is just going to be the Miyota 6S21 movement that is going to be activating there. So don't be concerned, this is a Quartz movement. The crown is going to operate in typical fashion. One point of emphasis though is going to be at the farthest pulled out point. Now you can't set the time here, but the other interesting note is going to be when dealing with some of these Quartz movements, misalignment of that second hand can happen. And when that is the case, this movement can correct itself by using that top pusher. You can manually go ahead and adjust the position of that second hand to allow perfect precision and alignment of that second hand where you need the chronograph hand to be. This is kind of a hidden trick with these movements that some users are not aware of. And for those that are very meticulous about where that alignment is, this is a good fail safe. Given the marine undertones of this piece in reference to a surfboard, also with that screw down crown, this one is going to achieve 200 meters of water resistance. And for a chronograph, I don't think I need to say that that is exceptional. In terms of finishing, this piece combines vertical brush to the top side surface of the case and polish along each of its sides and in between the lugs with the hard transitions between the two. Atop the case sits a bi-directional anodized blue and red bezel that rotates smoothly in each direction. You'll notice that the bezel has an unusual countdown configuration rather than displaying the traditional lapse time, as the minute intervals descend rather than ascend, which was also featured in the original 1970s models. Tying the bezel together is a relatively large loom pip, breaking up the blue and red segments of the bezel at the 12 o'clock position. The countdown bezel is incredibly useful and I find is actually more readable when it comes to timing different events compared to a time elapsed bezel. It's just a bit easier visually to see time elapse in that manner rather than the typical way. The Chrono A is supplied with a blue silicon rubber strap between the 20 millimeter lugs. There's a woven type texture given to the top of the strap and is perforated all the way up and down with diamond or square shaped holes in which the center section of these holes are used to secure and adjust a butterfly clasp. The deployant clasp has a 2-button release and its nearly all visible surfaces are polished. If you are deciding to change the strap, just keep in mind there is a slight taper down to that buckle from the strap end. Transitioning over to the double dome sapphire crystal, we have a clear view of the blue and silver surfboard dial beneath. Along the outer edge of the dial, we have a printed tachymeter scale to measure the speed when using the chronograph. Just to the inside of that, we find the applied faceted markers, which contain a thin segment of luminous material. In addition to being highly polished, the indices give the dial just a bit of depth when combining it with that step-down surfboard section. It's this section that contains the chronograph sub-registers, complete with the vintage-inspired red hands. The left register measures 1-hour intervals, while the right register is the running seconds hand, which is always active except when the crown is fully extended with the hacking seconds feature. The hour and the minute hands are paired with the red chronograph second hand and are painted primarily white with red tips, fitted with more lume. Overall, the lume is adequate, with the pip glowing a bit brighter and stronger than the dial elements when charged up with artificial or natural light. As far as the dial colors go, there are going to be a variety of options here, so please keep that in mind. This particular version has a matte deep navy blue that appears darker than the bezel beneath the crystal. The surfboard section also has a matte finish to it, but there is some granular metallic sparkle that gives some pop that helps bring the dial to life. But there's no question about it, this is a watch that is going to lean into those retro 1970s vibes, and this is probably one of the better executions of doing it in this price range. Flipping the watch over, we have a simply decorated screw-down case back with a lot of open space, but underneath sits the Miyota 6S21 quartz movement, which features, of course, the chronograph function, as well as hours, minutes, seconds, and a hacking seconds. As quartz technology is much more accurate than even the most advanced mechanical technology, you're going to get fantastic accuracy within plus or minus 20 seconds a month on average with this piece. The movement is also designed for 3 years of battery life under normal operation, so standard battery replacement intervals should be few and far between. Also, just keep in mind, if you're not running the chronograph all the time, which you probably shouldn't, then that's only going to allow this to be even further exaggerated. One final note on this movement is that it ties back into the setting of this watch. There is a date function that is available with the 6S21, which has been removed from this piece, which is why there are going to be a dead or ghosted crown position. Just keep that in mind. Don't get scared. You didn't break your watch, but that is just kind of what's going to come with this movement. The other great thing about this movement is it's going to have some sweeping to that second hand, not nearly on the same level of playing field as that of a mechanical movement, but say a more traditional low beat movement. It's almost there in terms of its sweep, but I think this is going to allow a lot of upside for people that maybe are quartz snobs and don't have to necessarily make a compromise here in terms of the looks, while of course getting the accuracy and reliability that comes with the quartz movement. So now some final closing thoughts on this Chrono A. In the past, I did look at the mechanical option of this surfboard chronograph, and candidly, that one on price fell in a range where you were getting into some tough competition for a watch that's this quirky in its design. It's going to be a tough ask for many people out there unless you truly love the limited edition offering that was being provided there, but I totally get the sentiment for many people that are just not going to look in that direction for something that is kind of this out there in terms of design. But when you twist the conversation over to looking at this piece, much of the foundation of an argument for or against it is going to be different. This watch remains very true to the original design. It also isn't going to go beyond the bounds of what is truly possible in terms of case size and wearability for a mass market type of appeal. 40.5 millimeters with the case and also a 46.5 millimeter lug to lug distance is going to really sit in a nice sweet spot for many wrists out there. 200 meters of water resistance, a movement inside that's going to offer some mechanical looks with its sweep, but the quartz upside in terms of its accuracy, box sapphire crystal that's going to add some vintage flair to its aesthetic while upping the durability in the scratch resistant department. I think this particular version in the quartz variety is a much easier package to stomach compared to that of the mechanical variety, given you're not going to have to pay an arm and a leg to get into this world. And when it comes to a watch that leans into that eccentric, fun, kind of more out there type of flair from the 70s, this is in a price range where it's much easier to stomach. And I could see this being a fun weekend watch that you can just pull out for certain types of arrangements or something that just leans into an era that maybe you can look back to in a fond memory or whatever sort of kind of vantage point you want to take. And from a chrono of this variety, there probably isn't going to be many better options when you factor in the history behind this piece. This is a true design to Bulova's archive, while also kind of checking off many of the boxes when it comes to wearability, reliability, and of course looks at the end of the day that I think are going to allow these to separate from much of the competition. All right, guys, well, thank you again so much for watching. If you did enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and hit the bell icon. That really does help out the channel, and I would appreciate it. Also, if you're in the market for this watch, check it out on teddybaldestar.com, full authorized dealer of all the brands that we carry, quick and fast fulfillment, dedicated customer support. We also offer a full factory warranty for all the products that we offer. So if something goes wrong, you're not having to pay the bill for it, and that can get expensive. Also, we offer price match, so if you see one of our watches for cheaper at another authorized dealer, fill out the form, we'll get in touch with you. And finally, 9 out of every $10 that we generate goes right back in the content that we're creating here, as well as on our main channel, helping to foster up a new generation of watch enthusiasts in the process. But guys, thank you again so much for watching. Be well, and I will see you all very soon.